He has loved us. He has made us his children. This is the love of God. Now hold on to that love. And let anybody think anything, anybody do anything, don't bother. See to it that what that comes from outside, do not take away the courage, the love, the faith God has given to you. Hold on to your God and hold on to what He gives to you. The inner courage to face anything, the inner peace that tells you God is in control of your life. And the courage that the Lord who is in you will turn everything into good in His time. So, the renewal of life is, you face the things that are coming against you with the truth that God is in you and He is with you. And all those who live by that truth, they never bow before the situation. Rather, they see as they walk, the situations bow before them. When you walk with God, at times you think you have come to an end. Then when we close only, when we go close, we find it is not end, it is a bend. God may take you to another direction. Or everybody has left me. Everything is gone. Now what will I do? How will I live? You are thinking as though you are coming to an end. But the Lord with whom you walk, He never takes you to end. Because He is endless. So He will take you into a bend. He will take you in a different direction. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So keep alive that love of the Lord. Keep alive that faith God has in you. And live out that love, because that is very important. The world has so much of Satan. The world has so much of dirt. The world has got so much of sin. So don't simply get discouraged and disappointed because the world is doing to you. The world thinks of you. The world treats you. Jesus said in John 14:30, the ruler of the world is coming behind me. He never even left me also. How will He leave you? But be courageous. I have overcome the world. He will have nothing to catch me, because the Father, the Holy Spirit is in me. Now the Father, Son and the Holy Spirit are in us. Yes. The world will come behind you. Means the world that accuses will accuse you. Oh, you are so and so. They will remind you, when you are that age, you did this. They will come with the lust to attract you, to pull you down. They will come with accusation. They will say what you have not done. Or what you have done, they will make known and embarrass you. That is the nature of the world. But you don't worry. Be aware of the Lord in you. Never give up yourself. You are not created to become victim to the situation. The one who lives in you. That's why in Romans chapter 8, verse 30, 5 onwards, St. Paul says, who can separate me from the love of my God? Neither sickness, nor any situation, nor peril, not even angels. No. In all these things, we are victorious by the one who has loved us. Keep alive this. Romans 8, 39. Who can separate me from the love of my God? Yes, that's why St. Paul writes in another place, in Galatians chapter 2 verse 20 he says, it's not no more I, it is my Lord lives in me. I live by the one who has loved me and gave his life for me. Keep alive this. It's no longer I who live. My Lord lives in me. Who is that Lord who has loved me? And knowing I am a sinner, he forgave me. He loved me and gave his life for me. I keep alive this truth. I live by the one who loves me and gave his life for me. When you say that, you see the blood of Jesus coming and healing you, cleansing you, forgiving you, making you his child. Every day meditate on this. Every day hold on to this truth. It's no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me.
Praise the Lord.
So be aware of the Lord in you. And with him, handle the situations. And one of the situations which we deal today is when you are hurt, when you are wounded, if you are not aware of it, as we read in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 verse 15, the hurts, the memory of hurts, the past wounds, the past what people spoke about you, in the past what the blunders you did, it can remain in your memory, and Satan can use that memory. The moment you want to pray, he may stop you. We know what you did, stupid fellow. You are a sinner and you want to pray? Keep quiet. Satan will be talking. You have to tell, get lost. I live by the one who has loved me and gave his life for me. It is the moment you hold on to the word, you shout. Shout the truth. It is no longer I, my God lives in me. I live by him, not by me, not by what I have done. Today I am forgiven, not by what I have done, but by what he has done, by what he is to me. Today I am saved, not because of what I am to him or what I have done for him, but because what he is to me. You can't take away the relationship of father and son, father and daughter. Maybe the world may leave you, your wife may leave you, husband may leave you, the world may even accuse you, let them do, but they cannot take away what the Father, what Jesus is to us. Keep alive that truth and celebrate. Because the Bible says, what the world does, the accusation, the hurts, the blaming, it will become poison. For what? To take away the truth from us, that God of glory is in us. Make us to think to what others think is right. You hear the falsehood and you make it that is true and you behave accordingly. He is telling you are good for nothing. So I am also saying you are good for nothing. I forget who I am in the Lord. I begin to react to what the lies is spoken about me. So be careful. That's why Jesus said, even on the cross, as he was, they accused him, blamed him, but he never gave up his goodness. So when he was aware of the Father in him, he was living in the goodness of God. Don't give up the goodness of God. That's why David said in Psalm 23 verse 6, till the end of my life, all the days of my life, his goodness and kindness shall follow me. All the days of my life. That's why in Romans chapter 5 verse 7 and 8 it is written, maybe a good man may die for another good man, While we are still sinners, Jesus died for us and has told us, my goodness will never leave you. While we are still sinners, he died for us and proved his goodness and love for us. Nobody can, no issue, no sin of mine has the capacity to take away the goodness of God from me. That is guarantee. So Jesus gives that goodness even to those who persecute him. He says, my Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do. Luke 23:34. This is the love of Jesus, the goodness of Jesus. In the tree of goodness, there are flowers which are known as forgiveness, which we call it in Telugu and Tamil, mannimpu. Adi oka pu, mannimpu. Yes, the forgiveness is a flower that blooms in the goodness of God. You keep alive that goodness. When you keep alive that goodness of God in you, you too begin to bloom with his presence. Praise the Lord. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.